Hello YouTubers!
Hello YouTubers! We are here for you guys today with the
highly requested sleek review.
Yeah, and we've got a few blushes we will talk about and eyeshadow palette.
We have still 5 of the blushes. We have been giving away a few of them
because we kind of don't like the shimmery ones too much. And also we know there's that rose gold blush by Sleek, which is really, really hyped. And honestly, we don't like it very much. So we gave it to our friend Kristen. Kristen, I hope you like it. We didn't.
And the ones we still have are more on the matte side. And those are Pixie Pink.
Coral.
Pantau. Flushed and Sahara.
Our favorite out of the bunch is definitely the orange one, the Pantau, because it's a very special color and it also is kind of a little bit softer in texture than the other ones. Unfortunately, this was limited edition, but we know Sleek has got a similar one in their permanent line now.
And as you can see, we have just matte ones anymore because we didn't like the shimmery ones, and we have bright colors in general. Sleek blushes, we would say they are good for the price. You can get good product and they are very good in pigmentation.
They go on very well, they are blendable, and also they last for quite some time. But a lot of people compare them to NARS blushes, and honestly we have a lot of NARS blushes and we don't think they are comparable at all. But good for the price.
And then we have a Sleek product which we really love. We both love it. It's the Sleek Face Contour Kit in Light. This is the one with the bronzer and the highlighter. Both are great. The bronzer is beautiful, goes on beautiful, very nice for contouring.
I'm wearing that actually today for
contouring the face and also for bronzing up the face, and the highlighter is gorgeous. And here they are, the highlighter and the bronzer.
They are a really, really nice sculpting kit. With the highlighter, you really can have a nice highlight on the cheekbones, or you can use it as an eyeshadow, which is beautiful also, and use the bronzer in the crease or in the face. This product is just really, really gorgeous, and we really would recommend it.
And we really would repurchase it.
Definitely. Yeah. Now let's move on to a product we didn't like at all and we can't recommend, and this is the Sleek Pout Polish. We got that in a set from a limited edition. Ours is in Sugar May, and these pout polishes, they are very, very sheer. They look like that. They are supposed to be kind of a lip balm.
I gave up on this product pretty soon.
Honestly, it's not really moisturizing. It tastes plasticky. It doesn't do anything for my lips. And just to show you, look at that. It's just, I don't know. It's very sheer. I mean, it doesn't matter what kind of coloring you choose with this kind of pout polish, because they all look the same. I mean, you can see nothing really. And it smells okay, but once you put it on the lips, it tastes so plasticky. I really don't like it. I don't want to use it up, and Brigitte doesn't like it either. So pout polishes,
we don't like it. Now to a product we have mixed feelings about, Sleek eyeshadows.
Yeah, we had a Sleek eyeshadow palette before and we didn't really like it.
We gave it away also, so we can't show you anymore.
We thought now that the Sleek eyeshadows might be reformulated, because it used to have a pattern on the eyeshadows and they don't anymore. So we thought, okay, let's try it again.
And we have the All Natural palette from Sleek,
which for us neutral girls is definitely the best one to go for. And the palette itself is really beautiful.
Colors are beautiful. And what we have to point out with the eyeshadows is that we like the matte eyeshadows a lot more than the shimmery eyeshadows. Mm-hmm. Same as with the blushes. The formulas for the matte eyeshadows are really good. They're really nice, blendable. But as darker as the eyeshadow goes and as more shimmer is in the eyeshadow, the more patchy they are.
Yeah, that's true. And with the shimmery darker eyeshadows, there's no chance we can work it into the crease, because it just doesn't work. I can't explain it. The texture is soft, but When you put your finger in it, it feels like there would be oil in it or something. I can't explain it. It's really, really hard to explain. I mean, we haven't used that palette too much, but look at that. I don't know. Can you see that? It's like if there would be oil in it or something. They swatch very nice on the finger, but with the blending brush, there's no chance. There's lots of matte shades in here, so the two shadows we don't like in this palette is this one and this one. The two kind of
darker, shimmery colors.
Yep. Maybe we just don't like the shimmery powders from Sleek at all, because we had the same kind of problem with the blushes.
The only shimmery product we do like from Sleek is the highlighting powder in this face contour.
That's a shimmering product that we really like. Would we say go out of your way to get that because it's so hyped up?
Definitely not.
Because we know when they ship to the US, they have quite high shipping prices. But if you're in the UK or something, definitely go to Superdrug and check these palettes out. But otherwise, we can honestly say there's no need to go out of your way to get these eyeshadows, because yes, they are hyped up, but in our opinion, Wet n Wild eyeshadows are a lot better.
And Catrice eyeshadows are a lot better.
So if you want to try out Sleek, check out a palette that hasn't got too many dark shimmery shades in it.
And just to let you know, our favorite shades in this palette is this blending color here.
That's beautiful.
This is just the perfect blending color. And this black eyeshadow here in the palette, this is just such a dark black. Really, if you use this black as a liner, you won't be able to see a difference to your black track or to your gel liner in general.
It's got lots of matte shades in it, and this lighter shade goes on all right. Just to pat it on the lid, that's all right.
And it looks really, really beautiful. Cornelia is wearing this shade on her lids today, and I think it looks very, very pretty.
I've done a little demo on my eye look with this palette today, which we will be showing now. I have already applied the Urban Decay Primer Potion in Eden. Now I'm taking the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk, and I'm gonna apply that in the inner tear duct and up on the brow bone. First, I'm starting off with that matte shade in here, and I'm gonna put that on the brow bone and in the inner tear duct. Then I'm taking the shimmery shade in here, which is the last one in this first row, and I'm gonna put that all over the lid. Then I'm taking this darker shade here, is the first one in the second row, and I'm gonna apply it on the outer corner and blend it inwards. Can you see that? That's exactly how these eyeshadows go on. With that same shade, I'm gonna go onto my lower lashes at the outer corner. These eyeshadows do have a little bit of fallout, but fallout is not a problem for me because I'm doing the foundation afterwards anyway. To blend out, I'm using this beautiful matte shade, which I really do like. These eyeshadows are not bad, but they're just really so much harder to work with. The matte ones are really nice, but especially the darker shimmer shades are so hard to work with. And with a smaller brush and a lighter shade again, I'm gonna go onto the lower lash line. To To blend out on the brow bone, I'm going to go into that lighter shade again. And I want to darken up the outer corner a little bit more, so I'm going to go in with that darker shade here and the shadow brush. Right, here you have the eyes done, the liner is on, mascara is on, a very nice neutral look, and I hope it was helpful for you to see how these eyeshadows apply also. As we said, you don't need to go out of your way to get one of these palettes, honestly. There's so many good eyeshadows out there.
If I ever go to the UK, I would definitely go to the drugstore and check out the brand again, because we like the matte formula from Sleek, and due to that we would go and check out the pressed powder from Sleek, which would be really interesting.
In the future we probably will try the pressed powder one
and
day.
And lipstick, of course. We never have tried any Sleek lipsticks, and yeah, we are curious about them.
And when I was in the UK, the other thing you hear about are the Pout paints. And I really wanted to pick one up, but I went to two or three different shops and I looked at the Sleek display, and all the Pout polishes, they were separating. So I didn't know if the quality was there. I don't know, they just really looked awful. This brand does make us curious about how the products are, but
yes,
in our opinion, we really only can recommend matte eyeshadows. The matte blushes are nice.
And the face contour kit we definitely can recommend to everybody. This is a really great product. We have mixed feelings about the Sleek products, the shimmery products especially. We have never found any shimmery product except of the highlighter in here, which worked for us.
This is just our honest opinion, and we can't be all positive about it because we don't like all of the products. As we said, we wouldn't go out of our way to get these products again, but if we're in the UK, we definitely will go and check Sleek out. So now let's move on to the faces of the day. You have already seen my eye look. Or if I line up the Black Track Fluidine, the mascara is the Rocket Mascara by Maybelline and the Essence. As a last coat, the Essence Multi Action and a flesh-toned pencil in the waterline. On my face I'm wearing the Benefit Professional Primer, the Leo Ellie BB Cream, the Revlon Nearly Naked Powder. It's kind of one of my current favorites at the moment.
Oh,
I really,
wow,
really love that powder.
Cornelia found a face powder which she really likes.
Yeah, for now. Hopefully it will hold up. To set under the eyes, my Guerlain Meteorites powder and the Garnier Anti-Roll-On for a little bit of brightness underneath my eyes. To warm up my face, that bronzer from the Sleek Contour Kit in Light, and my highlighter is also the highlight part in that Sleek Contour Kit. And my blush is the Tarte Exposed. On my lips I'm wearing the Gauche Lip Liner in Nougat?
Yes,
Nougat Crisp. The Kate Moss Lipstick in number 19. And on top, the Essence Lip Gloss, the Essence Stay With Me Lip Gloss in I Like Cotton Candy.
My face primer is the Clinique Professional Face Primer, and then I've used the Misha BB Cream on top of it and set everything with the MSF in Medium Plus. For under the eyes, I have used my Garnier Roll-On Concealer and the Catrice Eyeshadow in Bring Me Frosted Cake. My bronzer is the Nude On Board Bronzer. And for blush, the inner part here from the Semi-Precious Pearl Mineralized Skin Finish.
It's all by MAC.
Yeah, and the highlighter, yeah, is the outer ring. Here on my cheekbones and a little bit on my Cupid's bow. For my eyes, the Lorac Eye Primer with my Painterly Paint Pot. For my inner tear duct and my brow bone, I have used this white eyeshadow from the Sonia Kashuk Matte Eyeshadow Palette, the Eyes On Neutral. For all over the lid, I also have used this highlighting shade from the Semi-Precious Pearl. In my crease, this beautiful lighter brown eyeshadow, and to darken everything up, this darker brown eyeshadow. Very simple and quick eye look. For mascara, as always, the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes and the Isle of Extreme on top of it.
By Essence, yeah.
The Black Track Fluid Line as a liner and to tight line. And on my waterline, the Scandalize Eye Pencil from Rimmel in Nude.
Which is one of her current obsessions at the moment, because she can't stop wearing it. She wears
it
every day now.
That's true. And my favorite lipstick at the moment,
which she also wears every day now.
It's the Revlon Raspberry Lipstick. I'm loving it. And today I have used a red lip liner underneath it to get more of a red lip effect. And this is from Astor in Framboise. Yes, nails is the Bourjois 10 Days Anti-Chip No Jock.
Number 15.
Yeah, number 15.
And I'm wearing the Soya Lola nail polish. Ah, love that, love that.
I think I have to get another one next time when I go to Italy.
Beautiful.
It's really polish. Beautiful. It's just a beautiful summer color.
Yeah.
The Lola in from Soya.
So this was it for the video. We hope you appreciate our real and honest opinion about sleek products and enjoyed our faces of the day.
Thanks a lot for watching.
Lots of love from Cornelia
and Brigitte.